Well, everyone seems anxious over what the future holds. Men's hearts are failing them for fear, and love is growing cold. Heartaches and broken homes are reasons folks are insecure. But if this old world should end tonight, I know salvation will be sure. And I'll keep on singing till he gets here. I'll keep talking about my Lord. Get down on my knees each day, take time to read his word. I'll share the good news of salvation with people every day. Nothing's gonna keep me from going home when he calls me on that day. Well, I can hardly wait to see my Jesus in the air. Enjoy eternal pleasures with the saints from everywhere. And when I see him coming, I'll say, Lord, here am I. And he'll say, well done, faithful one, come on and meet me in the sky. And I'll keep on singing till he gets here. I'll keep talking about my Lord. Get down on my knees each day and take time to read his word. I'll share the good news of salvation with people every day. Nothing's gonna keep me from going home when he calls me on that day. And nothing's gonna keep me from going home when he calls me on that day.
Amen.
Plenty of room in the family, room for the young and the old. Plenty of happiness, plenty of love, plenty of room in the fold. Plenty of room in the family, room for the young and the old. Plenty of happiness, plenty of love, plenty of room in the fold. Plenty of food on the table, no need to economize there. You know there's all you can hold and more besides, and the storehouse will never be bare. Plenty of food room in the family, room for the young and the old. Plenty of happiness, plenty of love, plenty of room in the fold. Where if you're lonely and looking for friendship, and you're lost but you want to be found, well, there is plenty of room in the family of God, and plenty of love to go round. Plenty of room in the family, room for the young and the old. Plenty of happiness, plenty of love, plenty of room in the fold. Plenty of happiness, plenty of love, plenty of room in the fold.
Amen.
I was telling Jerry that I'm in the process of learning some foreign languages, one of which is Chinese. The first phrase I learned was, Sun Ting Wong.
Don't quit your day job. Don't you just love the hymns of the church?
Amen.
I remember when I would go home from the academy. I spent 4 years at Indiana Academy. I'd go home from the academy. And sometimes I just refused to sing the hymns because it seemed like the piano player would play them so slow that it just almost go to sleep. But now that I've gotten older, I just love the hymns of the church. I loved them back then too, and I knew most of them by heart. But when we sang that, how great thou art this morning, and that one verse that said he sent his son, not sparing, sent him to die to take away from my sins. It almost brings the tears to my eyes to realize that Jesus gave his life for me, that even a sinner like me could have eternal life. And I praise God for that, and what a wonderful life he has given us.
Amen. It's a wonderful life I'm living. Jesus is my best friend. He is loving and giving and pouring out blessings with mercies that never end. It's a wonderful life I'm living. Every day is better than before. And to think of all that heaven holds in store, I couldn't ask for anything more. When the sun rises in the morning, I see God's faithfulness. When I take a look around me, I'm reminded how much I'm blessed. With family and friends who love me, and a Savior who always cares. Through every trial and victory, He's promised to be there. Ooh, it's a wonderful life I'm living. Jesus is my best friend. He keeps loving and giving and pouring out blessings with mercies that never end. It's a wonderful life I'm living. Every day is better than before. And to think of all that heaven holds in store, I could ask for anything more. I lay down in the evening and pause for a moment to pray, recalling all the good things He sends along the way. Can't keep the tears from flowing, 'cause I'm filled with gratitude. And joy wells up inside me, my heart just sings a tune. Ooh, it's a wonderful life I'm living. Jesus is my best friend. He keeps loving and giving and pouring out blessings with mercies that never end. It's a wonderful life I'm living. Every day is better than before. And to think of all that heaven holds in store, I couldn't ask for anything more. And to think of all that heaven holds in store, I couldn't ask for anything more.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Trail to heaven above, where the Savior reigns with compassion and love, where the flowers bloom and spread their sweet perfume, and the birds are singing a heavenly tune. The cows in the meadow are happy today, for God has planted their way. Everything sublime in that sunny clime. Oh, what a wonderful day. so sweet at the Savior's feet, up a winding trail with you, up a winding trail with you.
For many years I wandered, oh, so aimlessly through life, with no hope of heaven where there comes no pain or strife. But now my sights are set upon that new range in the sky,
where we'll live together by and by. Hand in hand together we will roam, up that golden street to our new home. Life will be so sweet at the Savior's feet, up a winding trail with you, up a winding trail with you.
Amen.
You know, when the Lord told Samuel to go and anoint a new king over Israel, I've always found this interesting, because I'd always heard that a half-truth is a lie. I don't know if you've ever caught this, but Samuel said, "Lord, I can't go anoint a new king. If Saul finds out, he'll kill me." The Lord said, "Well, take a young bull and sacrifice to me there. That way, if Saul says anything," I'm putting Jerry Reedaboo's words, "if Saul says anything, you can say, you've come to sacrifice to the Lord." So I've always found that kind of interesting, and I know it couldn't have been wrong, or God wouldn't have told him to do that. But I do think we need to use discretion in our words, because the Bible says, by your words will you be justified or condemned. So God can see the heart. As Jesse's sons walked before Samuel, Samuel thought, "Oh, wow, this guy would make a great king." But God said, "I've not chosen him." All of them went. And finally, he said, "Have you no more sons?" And Jesse said, "Well, yeah, the youngest one, but he's out. He's just a youth. He's out watching the sheep." Samuel said, "Well, go get him." And God said, "This is the man I have chosen. He's a man after my own heart." And I know that a lot of folks like to quote that after David sinned with Bathsheba, but it's very clear that David was a man after God's own heart, except in that one thing. David was not perfect, and again, we have Jesus, because none of us are perfect. We're all sinners. So God can see the heart, and someone has written a song, "How About Your Heart," and we love to sing this song.
How about your heart? Is it right with God? That's the thing that counts today. Is it black by sin? Is it pure within? Could you ask Christ in to stay? People often see you as you are outside. Jesus really knows you, for he sees inside. How about your heart? Is it right with God? That's the thing that counts today. How would you feel your heart were made with a window on each side, so that all could see not just outward charm, but reveal it inward heart. People often see you as you are outside. Jesus really knows you, for he sees inside. How about your heart? Is it right with God? That's the thing that counts today. That's the thing that counts today.
I would like to share something.
Oh, good. I was just wondering if you were going to say anything this morning, and you're going to let me do all the talking.
Because we're going to sing this one, Now I Will Serve Thee. And I felt impressed to say this. I am fruit of the big city. And I praise the Lord that one day, well, my parents, my grandparents actually, were the first generation of Adventists.
In where?
São Paulo, Brazil, in the countryside. So a missionary went there and knocked on their door, and they got to know, it was a co-porter, but they didn't even know how to read. How is that so? So my grandma learned how to read, reading the Bible. And I praise the Lord today as we were studying what we studied in the Sabbath school lesson, that because of someone that left his comfortable zone, my grandparents got to know Jesus, and I'm here. I'm third generation of Adventists, and I grew up, I was born and raised in the big city in São Paulo, Brazil. It's like New York City for you guys here. And there is such a, I'm glad that I'm from the 60s, late 60s, so back then maybe the cities weren't that bad. But it was bad enough. But something good can happen from those places. And the Holy Spirit wants us to step out of our comfortable zone and serve him. So I don't know, I don't think I will be going back to São Paulo. I'm enjoying life here in the country now. My husband is an American. I am now an American citizen by being naturalized, but I think it doesn't matter if it's here in North Vernon, if it's in Noblesville where we live, or still reaching out to those people that I still know in the big city that are still there, my big part of my family. We can step out of the boat of our comfort and serve him with all that we have. So thank you for letting me share my story with you.
I will serve thee because I love thee. You have given life to me. I was nothing before you found me. You have given life to me. Heartaches, broken pieces, ruined lives are why you died on Calvary. Your you have given life to me.
Amen.
Denise doesn't like me to say this, and the last time I said it, she forgot her words the whole next song. But we started doing music at camp meeting 3 or 4 years ago in the morning meeting, doing the song service. And I think we did it 2 years, and then the third year, maybe it was, Someone came up afterward and said, "Where's the little academy girl that was singing with you?" Because Denise's family came from Brazil, so she could only be there 2 days. And I said, "Academy girl," I thought. And I said, "Are you talking about the little gal with the curly hair?" And they said, "Yes, the little curly-headed academy girl." And Betty said, "Academy girl, she's a grandma."
Of two beautiful boys, 7 years old, twin boys. They live in Texas.
So, sometimes.
But now, Jerry, now that I am 50 officially, I can spread the news to the world.
Yes.
That I am a grandma. I am a very happy grandma.
Sometimes, you know, God is so good to us. There are times in our life when we say, "I've never loved him better than today."
Since Jesus came and found me and put his arms around me and all my binding fetters took away. Although I've loved him dearly and trusted him sincerely, I've never loved him better than today. I've never loved him better than today. I've never felt him closer on the way. And oh, how sweet the feeling when in his presence kneeling. I've never loved him better than today. Oh, blessed friend supernal, my hope of joy eternal, keep thou my soul till shadows flee away. Nightly I would pray, Lord, to end this pilgrim way, Lord. I've never loved him better than today. I've never loved him better than today. I've never felt him closer on the way. And oh, how sweet the feeling when in his presence kneeling. I've never loved him better. I've never loved him better. I've never loved him better than today. Amen. Ah, it's just so good to sing to the Lord. I just need to say something again. I just have this passion about Jesus and God and everything that is heavenly. And some people don't understand me, not because they don't understand the accent. It's just unfortunate that sometimes in our walk, I don't know what is missing, but that fire, that joy is not there. And then we may be misinterpreted when we express that, but I'm not embarrassed. I am not ashamed. And you know, I was talking about being from another country, and this song is just so, it speaks to my heart, because home actually is not in Brazil. Home is not here in the States, because of a paper, maybe a document. No, our home is abroad, way up above. So our citizenship is in heaven, as we learned from the Word of God. And I am so excited to just share with you this feeling of, you know, being heaven bound, and soon we're gonna be done with all this. We will not need to pray anymore, only praises to God himself right there face to face. And I praise his holy name for the hope that we do have. And we sang a few minutes ago about this blessed assurance and this hope that we have. And that we may always remember that this is just a temporary thing, that we are here, but home is still to come. Heaven can be in our hearts, as we know we can already live with all this fire, this passion about everything that has to do with our Father in heaven. And that we, you may enjoy the words of this song as I do.
Like the joy his praises bring, of the sound of angel wings, it makes me feel so close to home. I like to see the smiling face on a sinner saved by grace, it makes me feel so close to call me strange, I just love to speak his name. On bended knee, and suddenly I am not alone. When I say Jesus, I feel the glory from the throne, and it makes me feel so close to like to break the bread of life. His words are such a welcome sight. They make me feel so close to home. While I walk in a stranger's land, I feel a gentle, loving hand that makes me feel so close to home. Call me foolish, call me strange, I just love to speak his name. On bended knee, and suddenly I am not alone. When I say Jesus, I feel the glory from the throne, and it makes me feel so close to home. When I say Jesus, I feel the glory from the throne, and it makes me feel so close to home.
Makes me feel so close to home.
I'm glad that Denise lets me tag along with her and sing with her, because she is so excited about our Savior and our Creator. Mm-hmm. And we went for about a year, maybe a little longer, without singing anywhere because she was homeschooling and my life got unbelievably busy. I took a new job and I was working, actually going to work on Saturday night, getting back on Friday, so I was actually working 7 days. Anyway, that's a long story. But I am so thankful that things have led up, and now I'm working Sunday night through Wednesday, sometimes Thursday. So that's enough for an old guy, don't you think? I've learned in my life that I need to give my problems to Jesus, because he knows how to solve them and how to fix them, and he did fix that for us. And so listen as we sing, give them all to Jesus.
Are you tired of chasing pretty rainbows? And are you tired of spinning round and round? Wrap up all the shattered dreams of your life. At the feet of Jesus, lay them down.
Give them all, give them all,
give them all,
give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, and broken toys. Give them all,
give them all,
all to Jesus, and He will turn your sorrow into joy. He never said you'd only have sunshine. He never said there'd be no rain. He only promised a heart full of singing at the very thing that once brought pain. Give them all,
give them all,
give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, and broken toys. Give them all to Jesus, and He will turn your sorrow into joy. Give them all,
give them all,
give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, and broken toys. Give them all to Jesus, and He will turn your sorrow. He'll be there in your tomorrow. Yes, He will turn your sorrow into joy.
Amen.
Now, you may think that this young man over here is just like he's shaking his head no. I want you to play Gentle Shepherd. He's shaking his head no, but I've got him on the spot. I've got the microphone and he doesn't. Do you want Denise to hold? Oh, okay, I was going to say you could have Denise hold the other guitar.
I'm strong.
Yeah. When I grow up, I'd like to be able to play the guitar like this man does. Oh, you're not even plugged in yet. I've got one of those curly cords for my guitar. I don't use it very often because it's always pulling me toward the amplifier all the time. And curly cords have a kind of a reputation for going bad on you. So Jim's always teased me about my curly cord, and every time one of his straight cords, and I got a straight cord, now it's only like 6 foot long, but he had one cord for a while, and every time he plugged it in, it would pop and crack and make a noise, and he'd move it a little bit, and then it'd be okay. So I'm always telling him, you want to borrow my curly cord? Gentle Shepherd.
Thank you. gentle shepherd, come and lead us, for we need you to help us find our way. Gentle shepherd, come and lead us, for we need your strength from day to day. There's no other we can turn to who can help us face another day. Gentle shepherd, come and lead us, for we need you to help us find our way.
What a friend.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. There's no other we can turn to who can help us face another day. Gentle shepherd, come and lead us, for we need you to help us find our way. For we need you to help us find our way.
Amen.
Would you like to hear Jim sing one by himself?
Yes, he has a beautiful voice. Okay.
That one song, what's the name of it?
He Means All to Me.
This is all unrehearsed, in case you hadn't known. That last song, this one. Yes, He Means All to Me. Get up here by the microphone so they can hear you. I think he's going to get even with me for doing that to him. He wasn't planning on singing that song, but I love the words of that song. What's next? This one? One Day at a Time.
That's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus.
and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
I'm only human, I'm just a man. Help me to believe in what I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb.
Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, as you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Pushing and shoving, crowding my mind.
Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
Guilty with nothing to say, and they were coming to take me away, but then a voice from heaven was heard that said, let him go. Take me instead, and I should have been crucified. I should have suffered and died. I should have hung on that cross in disgrace, but Jesus, God's Son, took my place. The crown of the spear in his side, oh, the pain it should have been mine.
rusty nails, they were meant for me. But Christ took them, and he let me go free. And I should have been crucified. I should have suffered and died. I should have hung on that cross in disgrace, but Jesus, God's Son, took my place. I should have hung on that cross in disgrace, but Jesus, God's Son, took my place.
It has to be love. love you can't miss, 'cause heaven's no miss, it has to be love.
You know, if we came back next Sabbath to this church, there probably would be someone missing, maybe two or three people missing. So I want to say this right now. It has been a joy to be here, and we have three more songs here?
No, just one. This is the last one.
This is the last one. Oh, yes. Those were if we were going to do anything later or something. Okay. Anyway, I want to see each one of you in heaven. And I will pray for you, and I solicit your prayers for me and my family and for all of us up here and Denise's family, Jim's family.
Yes.
The devil doesn't sit still a second. And he has a designer temptation for me. He has a designer temptation for each one of you. He knew your father and your grandfather and your great-grandfather and your great-great-grandfather. The second commandment says, the iniquities of the fathers are visited upon the children of the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, but showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. So, take heart, dear brothers and sisters. Keep the faith.
Amen.
And may we all meet together in heaven.
Amen.
If we don't meet together here on this earth.
Amen.
Time has come and we're parting. Parting often brings us pain, and our hearts are made to wonder, shall we ever meet again? Promise you'll meet me when life is o'er, if we never meet again. Down by the river, on that bright shore, if we never meet. Waiting down by the river, where the roses bloom so fair, where the saints are gathering yonder, and I'll be looking for you there. Promise you'll meet me when life is o'er, if we never meet again. Down by the river, on that bright shore, if we never meet again.
shake hands if we never meet again.
Amen.
So that's what I want you to do, is promise you'll meet me in heaven.
And me too.
And all of us, all of us. Shall we stand?
Yes.
And ask God to bless us and go with us. Father in heaven, we are so grateful to you for your kindness to us. You've been so very, very generous to each one of us. We live in what I consider to be the greatest country in the world. But we know that the way things are, they're changing fast. And we know that eventually this country will give up all the rights of its citizens and be demanded to worship on a spurious Sabbath, be demanded to do things. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you will give us strength to stand and be with our children and our grandchildren, that they will have strength to stand and be true. And may we all meet in heaven when Jesus returns. In Jesus' dear name, I ask these things. Amen.